Today's Power Query Challenge is going to stretch your transformation muscles as we tackle advanced conditional splitting. The task is simple but tricky. We have a list of IDs. If an ID has an even number of characters, we'll split it into two columns at the midpoint. If the ID has an odd number of characters, we will split it into three parts: the characters before the middle one, the middle character, and the characters after the middle one. And here is the catch. We will do it without any helper columns. Just simple, concise transformation. Let's dive in. First things first, we need to work directly with the values in the column. To do that, create a new step in the Power Query editor and reference the column name in square brackets, ID. This transforms the table column into a list. Why? Because lists are easier to manipulate when applying other functions. Next, let's bring the real magic, the List.Transform function. Right now nothing happens, because the underscore symbol is just a placeholder for the values in the list. Think of it as saying, here is the value, now what do you want to do with it? What we want is the length of each ID, so we add text length. Now Power Query calculates the number of characters in each ID. This will be critical for determining where and how to split the values. Let's take it even further by turning each value into a record. Records in Power Query allow us to store multiple pieces of information, like the length of the text and the calculated splits for each value. To do this, wrap your logic in square brackets and create a variable like this. This creates a record with a single field called len. You can later refer to it in the formulas. Now let's calculate the midpoint for splitting the text. Add another field to the record. Here, number round down ensures that even if the length is odd, we get a usable midpoint. For example, if the length is 5, half becomes 2. Now comes the main part, splitting the IDs into the desired format based on whether the length even or odd. We'll create a third field called result and write this logic. If the length is even, split into two halves and add an empty string for the third column. If the length is odd, split into left, middle and right parts. Here's how it looks. This formula uses Text.Start, Text.Middle and Text.End to extract parts of the text based on the half value. Now we need to extract only the result field from the record. At the end of our formula, just add a result in square brackets. This returns a list of lists where each inner list contains the split values. Finally, we'll turn the list of lists into a property. Use the table from rows function to do this. Here, the second argument specifies the column names. And voila! Your IDs are now split exactly as needed. By the way, does this technique remind you of any Excel function? Drop your thoughts in the comments, I'd love to hear them. So there you have it, a clean and efficient way to split text conditionally in Power Query without helper columns. If you found this useful, give it a like, share it with your colleagues, and don't forget to subscribe for more challenges like this. Bye for now!